Hi guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to do an all keys lost for the 2017 Honda Accord EX with smart entry or keyless entry using the Autel MP808TS. This should also work for other similar Honda with keyless entry. Now let's get this. If you follow this channel, you will know that I recently added a smart key to this car. Actually, this one, which is still uncut. This is my current key. I had slipped it into the sleeve. I'll demonstrate in a bit. I've slipped it into this sleeve just for ease of differentiation. So I had used this existing key to add this one. And all keys lost makes no use of any existing or master keys and is ideal for when you buy a used car and it's delivered without the full set of keys. This was exactly my case. I only got one key, which is this one. This is something I highly recommend you do if you find yourself in a similar situation. I once heard of a cartel that specialized in withholding a spare key only to later trace and show up on your driveway and just drive the car away using the spare key. Talk about gone in 60 seconds with no fuss. In order to give you the best value for your time, I had gone ahead to actually delete the key I programmed 2 weeks ago from the memory, and as it stands, it no longer works in this car. Let me demonstrate. Both keys, I'll go ahead to place them on the dash and then start the car. So car starts. So I'll take out the existing key or the current key to the car. Open the door and drop it there and then shut the door. So as you can see, just like last time, we now have this no key symbol despite the fact that this key is here. If I turn the car off and attempt to start the car, I'm stepping on the brakes and attempt to start the car. You see, it's not going to start the car, no matter how long I push it. So let's program. I'll go ahead to hit diagnostics. Now select Honda. I'll select system selection, select USA. So remember, the ignition is still off, but the tool is going to power on the ignition. Does this vehicle have a keyless access remote one push start system? I would say yes. Please hold the engine start stop button and I'll do just that. So you can see the ignition comes on, but what you also notice is that the immobilizer light also came on
because you don't have a key that works in the vehicle.
So please release the, okay, I've done that. Ignition switch has been turned on. Okay, I'll select hot functions. I'll select emo and keys. Yes, it does. Please take one original keyless access remote into the vehicle. I've already done that. Can you turn the ignition switch on by normal operation? The ignition switch is already on, so I'll just say yes. I'll select one push start. Keyless access control unit. Registration. Keyless access remotes. So I'll select all keyless access remotes lost. That's what we want to do. So it gives you a general description. This function does necessary registration when the keyless remote is deleted and registered. So a bit of funny English here. It's just trying to say that you should note the following while registering the key or while doing the all keys lost. To reduce interference, you should actually make sure that you separate the diagnostic tool from the key. So mine is on the dashboard here. I've also turned my mobile devices on flight mode so that I don't have any interference from there. Close all windows, sunroofs and doors while you're doing this. So again, it goes ahead to say if the customer has lost the keys, then this is when you should actually be doing the all keys lost. Talks about preparation, things you should have. One, ignition key registered in the immobilizer system. So we don't actually need a registered key, and you're going to see all keyless access remotes which need to be registered. That's if you want to register more than one key. Market setting, password, we don't need that. Talks about the procedure, which is all we've done up to this point. Connect the diagnostic tool, enter VIN and so on and so forth. We haven't entered the VIN, but this will work. we'll say, okay, it repeats the same things just so you make sure there shouldn't be any DTC diagnostic trouble code. There must be one registered keyless remote. There isn't any registered keyless remote. And the ignition switch must be turned on with the ignition key. This is the more important thing. So we'll say, okay, turn the ignition switch off, which we'll just do off. Please take one original keyless access remote into the vehicle. Can you turn the ignition switch on by normal operation? We can't, because this key on the dash is not registered. So on this occasion, I'm going to say no. We'll repeat the same thing again. We'll push and hold. And it turns on. So we'll say okay. How many keys I want to register? I'll just say one for now. Okay. And then it starts the process. So the immobilizer light is still blinking there. Turn the ignition switch off. We'll turn that off. Confirm that keyless access remote is in the vehicle. Yes, it is. That's it there. And we'll say okay. Turn the ignition switch on by key knob. Right, so this is the more important thing. So the key, we'll use it to turn the push the button twice. So that has come on now. I'll drop this, turn the ignition switch off. Again, turn the ignition switch on by using the key. We'll do that again. And we'll drop that there. Again. I bought the keyless access and immobilizer indicator lights turned off. They are both turned off. The immobilizer light, the green key, is no longer flashing down there. There's no key alert, so we'll say yes. The registration of keyless access remote has been completed. Turn the ignition switch off. Check all keyless access remotes to ensure that each will start the engine, and to lock and unlock the doors, turn the ignition switch on.
So let's turn the ignition switch on.
Ignition switch comes on. Immobi key is registered. We say okay. Keyless function is registered too. So,
and it goes back. And just to demonstrate now, so if I turn this off to start with and go to the door, this is now going to work. So you can see it's unlocking. Unlock. Unlock. So this key now works. I'll keep this key here. Let me start the car. So car starts, right? Then we'll open this. What we're going to do now, I'll take the programmed key out of the vehicle and then bring in the previous key that was working, right? You're going to see that this is no longer programmed. So you can see you're now having the no key alert. So that tells you this key no longer programmed to the car.
That's how you do all keyless access remotes lost on this 2017 Honda Accord. As I said, the procedure will work on other Hondas with smart entry. Like, share, and subscribe if you've loved this. Catch you on the next one. Peace.